Okay, welcome to Unit 2.2, where all we're going to talk about is polynomial functions. For the most part, you guys have seen lots of polynomials before, so I'm just going to be talking about a couple of simple things here. Should be a short video. So very first things first, what is a polynomial and, you know, what is a monomial, binomial? I've used these terms in class, so I want to make sure we understand what they are. A monomial is a polynomial. It's part of it, just like a square is a rectangle, but rectangles are not squares, right? So a monomial is a polynomial, but not all polynomials are monomials. A monomial simply tells me, excuse me, that I can just have some constant or a variable raised to a power, because technically next to this, you could have x to the zeroth power. Polynomials are going to be monomial functions that have sums and differences, so add and subtraction. So it really is what you've seen before. Those quadratic equations are polynomials. Okay, monomials are the basic form of a polynomial, and the big vocab word today is this right here, that leading coefficient. And what that is that's the coefficient of the variable with the greatest exponent. So all that means is if I have some example, for like, so, you know, where'd my pen go? Where is it? Come on, connect. There it is. Okay. So let's say I'm talking about my coefficient, and I've got, let's do x squared plus 3x cubed plus 7. Well, what is the number? What is the value real quick here? What is the term? What is the section that has the greatest exponent? And what a lot of kids will tell me is this one right here, because it's the first thing they see. But in reality, the greatest term is right here. What's the greatest exponent? Literally the exponent with the largest number. And that's this value right here. So I look at its coefficient, the number in front of the variable. And that's what I say my leading coefficient is. So my leading coefficient for this example is number 3 right here. My terrible boxing skills. My apologies. Okay, polynomials you already know. Well, guess what? You know quite a lot of them. There's a bunch of photos of some polynomials right here, but a lot of you might be paused right here on this constant function. How is that a polynomial? So I'm going to write out exactly why all of these are polynomials. If I can get my pen to pick up today, why isn't it picking up? Okay, so this one is actually x to the zeroth power, because anything to the zeroth power is just 1. So this is a constant, right? If this is a constant that looks like at approximately 4, this line is y equals 4. Technically, you can put an x to the zeroth power next to it. That's why constant functions are part of our polynomial also, because that f of x can just equal a. That's a monomial. This is our x function. This is x squared. At this point, I hope you're picking up a pattern. This is x cubed. If that's x cubed, this should be x fourth, and then it keeps going, right? So these are polynomials you've already seen before. You've worked with all of these at some point, and a lot of you should recognize our parent functions right here, okay? But what about polynomials and continuity? Again, we're just backtracking to concepts we've already covered in Unit 1. Polynomials are continuous. They are always continuous. They're always smooth lines, okay? Sometimes with rounded turns if you're talking about x squared and beyond. But the big thing we want to talk about, the new concept for Precal, is the leading term test. And all that tells me is end behavior. Okay, so let's recall end behavior. End behavior just tells me what's happening at the edges of the graph. Now, with polynomials, we have two very distinct types, and we're going to separate them out as to an even and an odd. And so in order to do the leading term test, we have to know two things. All we have to know is our... color is this yellow? Okay. All we have to know is the power and the coefficient, but not any power and any coefficient. It has to be the leading power and the leading coefficient. So you have to find that largest value. Okay. I've provided a pretty decent chart right here. You know, take a moment, pause, write down this chart as best as you can. On my next page, I also have another version of it, a visual representation, if you will. So, you know, depending on what makes more sense to you, the chart or the visual, you know, you decide what helps you. But let me read through all this is saying. This is simply saying that I have two different types of polynomials. I have polynomials with even degrees, x squared, x to the zeroth power, x to the 14th power, x to the 24th, anything that has an even exponent. And we have odd, you know, x cubed, x to the 5th, x to the 7th, x to the 33rd, all odd numbers. Then we have positive coefficients and negative coefficients. So if I know those two things, I know it's end behavior. If it's even, both my arms have to go the same way, always up or always down. If it's positive, it's up. If it's negative, it's down. And that's what this is telling you right here. If we're odds, we have opposite arms, okay? One's gonna go up and one is gonna go down. And when it's positive, then it's gonna look like that parent function cubic where I'm gonna start down and end up. But if I'm negative, we just switch that, start up and down. That's as simple as it. That's literally all I want from you for the leading term test. Can you tell me the end behavior? And since we're connecting back, you have to tell me end behavior with limit notation. So I'm going to make sure to model that for you right now. So first things first, let's predict our end behavior. I've created kind of a little cheat sheet for you here. So, you know, we need to identify our exponent as even or odd. We need to identify our coefficient as positive and negative. And then all I have to do is fill in the rest of this. And again, I pause and remind you, is this limit notation? Absolutely. Do not ever write your end behavior without limit notation. In fact, from here on out, anytime a limit is required, you just got to write it. You have to write it as a limit. I won't accept those without limit notation anymore. So first thing we're going to do is look at our exponent. What is the largest exponent? Is it 4? Is it 2? Or is it 0? Well, it's got to be 4, right? We're lucky. It's right there in the front. And what is it, even or odd? In fact, that 4 is even. Then we look at the coefficient of the largest exponent. So we go back to that 3. And what is it, positive or negative? It's positive. So again, if it's even, arms are going to face the same way, right? But if it's even and positive, arms are going to face up. That means I'm going to positive infinity and I'm going to positive infinity. Just to verify, I've got that chart right there for you. So even, positive, positive infinity, positive infinity. So that means my limit as x approaches negative infinity, I don't know if I'm mirroring, I don't know which way we go. As x approaches negative infinity, then my function is going to positive infinity. Then on the other side, it should also go to positive infinity. So I've got two more examples for you to test your mettle. Oh, also a self-check, my apologies. This is the actual polynomial graph. So you have an opportunity to say, oh yeah, even, positive, you see both arms going up. All right, here's another one, okay? First thing you have to ask yourself is, what is my exponent? Is it even or is it odd? Now, I'm gonna guess a couple of you told me that was an even exponent because you were looking at this 2 right here, which is the very first number that we see. But what should we always do? Shouldn't we check the rest of that polynomial? Because really, where is that largest exponent? It's right there in the middle, and it's actually an odd value. So I go back to its coefficient. Is that positive or negative? It's negative. So what does odd tell me? I've got arms doing the opposite direction. What does negative tell me? It tells me I start positive, I end negative. So that tells me from the left, it has to go to positive infinity. From the right, it has to go to negative infinity. And again, I can check right here, odd, negative. Look at those arms going positive infinity, going negative infinity. Okay, here's your self-check. It looks like it, not quite. It's got some little bumps in there, but for the most part, I've got one arm going down, one arm going down. I've got one more for you to do a self-check. What's my exponent? My biggest exponent is 3, which is an odd number. What's my coefficient in front of it? Technically, it's a 1, which is a positive number. So odd positive means I'm going to start down, end up. So that means my limit as x goes to negative infinity is also negative infinity. My limit as x goes to positive infinity is also positive infinity. So that's the leading term test. That's literally all it is. I'm not expecting much more than for you to understand how to use this chart, and however you memorize that works for me. The other thing I really want to talk about is what is a turning point. You know, turning points are just as easy as leading term tests. I promise you it's not that hard. All a turning point is telling me when the graph changes from increasing to decreasing. So you might also know this as like changes in concavity. Ooh, I can't talk. Changes in concavity or points of inflection. Like there's lots of different phrases that we can use to talk about that. We also know that this is where our max and our min are occurring, right? Because that's that change. But how do we predict what a turning point is going to do? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to predict two things today. We're going to predict how many real zeros, so this spot right here, and we're going to predict how many turning points. And that is a really simple formula, I promise. It's super simple. So we have this function, okay? What is my largest degree? Ooh, this is a little bit of a typo over here. That should have simply said squared. It just tells me I forgot to convert it. But what's my largest degree? It's that 6 right there. So we're going to deal with that number. Okay, that tells me n equals 6. So my largest, my leading exponent, my largest exponent, n equals 6. So my distinct real zeros are going to match my n value. My turning points are going to be n minus 6. So I'm going to write that down for you. So my real, where'd my pen go? There it is. Man, my pen is unhappy today. It does not like me. Okay, so real zeros. Bad pen. It's a bad angry pen. Okay, my real zeros are going to be...